Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today is the last video in which I show you some project that I did for my 12 days of Christmas swap with my friend Adeshda. I promised to make some videos with some more details of some of the projects. Today I'm going to show you three of them, the last three, and that is the big cake that I made, or the cake stand with the pieces of pie that I made, the mini album, and the popcorn box. And I will start with the popcorn box. Here it is. There's not so much to show on this. For the decoration, that's the only thing I'm going to show you, is I put a doily on top, paper doily, and I made a cluster with a rosette, a fabric flower, chipboard piece. I added this cute ribbon on top. These are also from the paper collection, and some big rhinestones from Action. And on the inside, I did show it, or I'm going to show it in a different video, in the videos that I show what I send out and what I received each day. So yeah, just some items that I bought for her to use for crafting and just to use in the household. The only thing that is really handcrafted is this cute box. I really like it. It's really small, so you can't put large things in it. But it's so cute to give in pearls, beads, some trims. I do believe I put in some trims for her. And on top is an embellishment I did last year with some wood veneers that I painted or heat embossed, and a shaker sticker, yeah, pipe cleaner that I put into a bow. So yeah, that's my popcorn box for her. Then the mini album. Here is the mini album I made for her. I really wanted to include an album in the 12 days of Christmas swap, so she can include her Christmas pictures that she made this year or last year or whatever in here. So yeah. For the base, I used the craft cardstock that I always use, and that's from Joycrafts here from the Netherlands, Dutch brand. It's so sturdy, and when you double it up, you have the best sturdy pages for your mini album. And I must be honest, for the shape of the page, I used a die that is part of a hardbox die that is designed by Nicole, I believe, and it's an older one from KS Crafts, and or from Alina Crafts, I'm not sure anymore. Or one of the other stores. Yeah, I'm sorry. It's an older die. So what I did is I only made a hinge here on the side. So one hinge. If I am doing this again, make another mini album with this die, I will put it here. So I would put two rings here, two hinges, because now it's a little bit hard to flip it when you have it not on the table. So when you have it like this, it really goes well. But yeah, you will see it. It's better to use two hinges instead of one. On the sides, I just glued some paper tassel that I made, also with a die from my stash. And I glued a cute paper rose on it, some trims that I have, some mesh, and of course a Christmas bell. It is closed just with a ribbon, with organza ribbon that I had in my stash. And on the front, I decorated it with a cute page that has a Santa, and I added some stickles on top. And everything you see are die cuts and chipboard pieces from the vintage, Simply Vintage North Pole collection from Simple Stories that I used. I added a pompon here to the Santa's head and some rhinestones, and I made this poinsettia flower with a die set from In Love Art. Every page is also a pocket page, so on top you can add or I put in some tags. And for the tags, I use the cut aparts from the paper collection. I put them on different paper and just decorated it with ribbon and this cute punch of a snowflake and a rhinestone. I will put it back after the video. When you flip this page, you see the first page, and try to zoom in a little bit better, and you can see it a little bit better. On this page, I just made a tuck spot with Starburst die that I have and a chipboard piece from the paper collection. I just decorated it with the stickers that come with the paper collection, and I die cut it out some cute tags. So you can journal or put pictures on here, and of course as well in the background. It's all mini, so it has to be small pictures, but I really like that. And I distressed everything in this album with a vintage photo distress ink from Tim Holtz. No, not vintage photo, walnut stain. Yeah, walnut stain. Here on this side, you it's quite some time that I created. Yeah, I created a flip up. So yeah, this can be flipped open and you have extra space for pictures and writing. And I just decorated it with stickers so you can glue over them if you want, or write over them, put a piece of paper there. And the front is just some die cuts, chipboard and stickers. So yeah, again, a different small tag on the inside. Then we go on. Here I made pockets, but I just used half of the die cut, as you can see. And I used an embossing folder for this. I really like this. It's an embossing folder, and I added some ink on top so that you can see the raised parts a little bit better. I used for decoration a flat bow that I made. And on the inside are these cute cutouts that I made as books. So yeah, they go in here. Next page is a mesh pocket that I did, and I used some pieces of the chipboard collection. And this is a candy that I made with foam with a die, and on the inside just some cute tags. And then as well, again, a small little tag. And then the pages repeat themselves, so you have the same layouts again. Here is just a simple page, so just decorated it with washi tape. This one is from the Simply Vintage North Pole, was gifted to me by the store that I bought it. I bought it at, I do believe it was Scrapwereld, and she added this as a present. So yeah, some snowflakes with rhinestones. And here now you can see it's the pages repeat themselves. They have the same layout, but just a little bit of different decoration. But the idea of the pages is all the same. Again, tag in the pocket. Then we flip up, flip again. Here is again a flip up that I made. Cute decorations. Here is again a simple page with a small tag. Here is again the pocket page with the mesh with some die cuts. So yeah, I just added a lot of pieces to write on or to put small pictures on. I hope she likes it. And the last page, the back page, I made a side pocket here. And I put in some cute little tags. I really like the ephemera that came with this collection. So yeah, and of course, a small tag on top. And then we have the back page, and I did nothing with it, just glued on beautiful paper. So yeah, this was the mini album that I made for Nadezhda. I hope she likes it. And now we go to the last project, and that's a big one, and that's this cake stand. So yeah, I really wanted to make a cake stand because I have a die in my stash that makes these cute boxes. I have it for quite some time, and I really wanted to make a big pie out of boxes, but of course I also needed to make a cake stand. Well, I'm not going to show you each and every box, but they are decorated on the outside the same, so with a paper flower, a gold fabric leaf, and with this cute star on the side. It's a fabric star from my stash. And on the inside I stuffed everything with small goodies. I used handmade goodies and pre-bought goodies. For example, Christmas bells. I am looking for something that I really like that I did make. But No, these are wood pieces for her to use. I am looking for something that I put together because I like it so much. Oh yeah, here I did some words for her, so some Christmas sentiments, and I used the words and the back pieces, so fa la 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 la, but I did some other words as well, joy, yeah, so she can use those. Well, I put it back afterwards, but I still am looking for something so cute. No, these are again words. Now I really wanted to see them or show them to you, because I made cute girls, Christmas girls, with a die that I had in my stash. And now, of course, I cannot find it. Oh, these are cute as well, from AliExpress, and I did put in some paper and the flatback camouflage for Christmas on them, so she can use them. I really like those. Didn't do anything else with them, so she can use them in a project of her own. No, just goodies. Again, goodies. Now, of course, this is the last box that I am going to open. You will see, these are some ornaments that I bought for her. Yeah, here they are. Mm-hmm. I made some cute girls. Oh, I love these so much. It's a die from my stash. You can use them on any project, but I made them in a Christmas version. I really love them. And yeah, different skin tones, different hair tones, different colors in their clothing or different prints in their clothing. I really like them. I hope she likes them as well and wants to use these on projects. And I made confetti to go on every box. So that's this. So yeah, that's this one. And then I will show you my camera is almost dying on me, so I have to be really quick. So yeah, for the cake stand, I have a glass bowl that I found. It came with a lid, so it's a bonbonnière to put bonbons in. I did not use a lid, I used this as the base. And I put a circle with chipboard on top. And I made this large circle, the plateau, with chipboard and patterned paper. I decorated the sides with this cute black dangle trim that I had in my stash for quite some time. And I added this gold rickrack and some really cute gold flowers, festive flowers, that I found on AliExpress. I hope I am in frame. So yeah, this is the middle of the cake stand. I made it with straw that I glued in. And I added some pompons here for decoration and for extra sturdiness. And I decorated this here with chipboard pieces from the collection. Fabric flowers, some rhinestone, some fabric stars, some pompons, and a beautiful hand crocheted flower in the back. Oh, I'm out of frame. I have to show this to you in frame. So yeah, that's this one. I really had fun creating this for her and I hope she likes it. It's a large piece to go in her craft room or in her living room for Christmas. And yeah, I hope she can use all the goodies that I put on the inside, but she probably can. So yeah, this was all that I want to show to you today. I think it's the last video from all my projects that I made for the 12 Days of Christmas swap. I'm really happy that you watched my videos and for your support. And I hope you will be back for my next videos. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.